Oh, he has. Also, and welcome back to a new video. And guys, today in this video, what I'm going to be doing is I am going to be carrying on with my the career mode test roughly. And also as well, I just finished recording a video where I checked out everything new in season 2, and as you can tell, it's a hooligan season because I've got bigger releases. Obviously, I bought the unicorn, and I just hope to I hope now that I don't need to buy a car because I'm gonna do the bigger issues. I'm gonna do the unicorn players because I just bought the unicorn in the last video. So I really hope that I made a mistake in that. So this. Oh, that's that. Oh, for God's sake.
You know where to find me, driver.
God's sake, this must be right. Where am I doing on again? You go on. Drive. Right, okay. Okay. Now I'm going to do my bit. Here we go. Chip kind of Grindmasters. Here we go. So,
let's
go. Here we go.
Here is the container. The Hoonigan Chief Creative Officer, Brian Scotto, has something to tell you.
Here we go. Here we go.
What up, everybody? Brian Scotto here from the Hoonigans, and this is the Gymkhana Grid Masters playlist. Have you ever listened, though? The crew at Motifest invited us out here to do what Hoonigan does best, and that's build a Gymkhana right here in Hawaii.
This,
we obviously need a driver that's ready to go fast and break a few things along the way. Before becoming a proper Gymkhana driver, you're going to have to master the craft, and that means a bit of workshopping and a lot of action. Driver gets a dope machine, and you will get yours. But first, you're gonna have to get to the end of this.
No room for cautious driving anymore. Here, you drive like a Hoonigan.
Right, so I'm going.
Just another activity awaits.
Right, stop.
Scott is waiting to introduce you to your new playground. Here, you're going to learn the ways of Hoonigan through various workshops set up by their team. Once your training is over, you'll be a real Gymkhana driver, capable of leading your own Gymkhana. But let's start at the beginning.
Welcome to Stunt Race. Perform multiple freestyle actions. Each action gives you points reach the objective and cross the finish line before the timers and to win the event. Okay, so this is like a stunt driving. I'm going to the unicorn. Long vehicle, so I'm guessing this will, this unicorn will have, I'm guessing will be.
Yo, what's up, Scotto here from Hoonigan. I'm super stoked to see another aspiring Gymkhana driver. And I want to welcome you to Tire Slayer Studios, our headquarters. The MotoFest gave us free reign to create our own Gymkhana grip playground and practice our craft.
Holy hell.
This is the place to hone and perfect our skills in three different level zones. Show me your creativity, and you might get your chance to become the Gymkhana MotoFest driver. But for now, let me just show you around. You're gonna love it here.
Why did you just put this car coming out of power? It goes, oh my face.
Looks like you're not the only one working out today.
Oh my god.
The driver is out to burn rubber.
Oh my word, it's
cool. There's no need to rush this morning.
It's way quicker than me.
Hey, this guy ahead, the car
I've got.
Great at donuts.
It's way quicker, oh my god. It's so much easier to do stuff like that. Oh my word.
The more tricks you perform, the more bucks you earn. But wait too long between tricks, and the buck counter will drop. That bonus is for true Gymkhana Masters only.
This is sick. And this is way faster.
Our 360 Madman is back. Go slide his line, just follow his tire tracks.
Trying to. Oh. It's so quick, this thing.
That's why I love this place. You have a wrecking ball, and you always have guys to get creative with. Performing the wildest tricks. This is the Gymkhana DNA.
Oh my god. Yeah, this is way more power than my one. Way more power. Holy hell, he's sick. Yeah, way more power. Let's see what.
It takes a bit of preparation to become a Gymkhana driver. A lot, in fact. But for now, just remember this. If you have the right mindset, you'll be capable of anything. Like drifting to the edge of a canyon, or jumping over a helicopter, or, I don't know, anything.
Whoa. That's a long one. One near that. This is sick. Done it.
Damn, we're coming to the end and I haven't even told you about this monster that spit fire out of its V8. I mean, you are driving the mother of all Mustangs. Cross that line and I'll tell you more about it.
Right. Come on.
So in the first event, you already get to drive the Hoonicorn. Realize that's the wildest Gymkhana machine we have ever built. You're a lucky one. It took us 2 years to transform a 1965 Mustang into that. The updated version uses the same Ford V8, but this time with two massive turbos. Let's see how you did on this first outing. We'll film a few moments, a good way to see how you progress through the playlist. It's gonna take some time for you to harness all of this power. This thing makes crazy torque. It's not exactly a ride for the beginners. All right, look, we're gonna keep the Hoonicorn, but we're gonna stay on the grid playground. I wanna see how accurately you can actually slide this thing around.
Okay. Well, yeah, that's great. But I guess you knew the things change. I guess more than that, I guess more like streamlined, like the money in parts is what the hell. Yeah, that's, I guess worth like that, to be fair. You know, it's faster as well. That's way better. So, well done. I'm going to rise. I'm going to daylight.
Come on, driver. The real Gymkhana quest starts now with your first drills.
Okay.
Score as many points as possible by performing the requested stunts, and you're sure to impress Scotto. Shouldn't be an issue. The Hoonicorn was born to stunt.
Get 2,600 points, so I care.
Okay, first training session. We're gonna wrap up the Hoonicorn part a bit. We're focusing on Gymkhana essentials: big slides and precision. Get the right amount of points, and we move on. Next trick, it's the grind rail. To grind these, you need to be properly aligned and to hit them at a high speed to slide all the way.
Oh, I mean, that's it.
On your right, and back again. Slide too wide.
Alright, I messed up.
Now toss it back the other way. Up for a little grind rail? Passing through these tunnels earns you... They force you to be precise. Come on, one last round. Give me a few more tricks.
We are nowhere near the blue pump system. We're nowhere near it. That worked out.
The first time we installed the grind rail was in Florida. We thought a car doing a skateboard trick? Man, that's gotta be cool. And it was. Step in the quest to becoming a Gymkhana master. The tricks we set up require a ton of precision and therefore training. Proper car control requires timing and impact. Everything is weight balance. Engage the brake hard at that perfect moment, get proper steering, but above all, never lift. Let's see how you handled your first slides with the Hoonicorn. Now the real test is going to be whether or not you can manage to put this all together in real Gymkhana conditions. First, I got this first ad I want to put together. There's two cars I want to see. Go head to head. Take your pick.
Okay.
way to hone your new skills. As Scotto said, let's take a break before resuming your Shinkana quest with a This Versus That episode.
I didn't mean this versus that.
Countless car-related things, from Custo to pro racing. But one of their favourite activities is as simple as it is fun, to compare cars by racing them.
Whoa.
Today, we're comparing two cars that are very special to our host.
Damn it.
You'll find out more later. For now, you just have to pick your horse.
Whoa. No. Okay, this versus that. Okay, so are you only going Porsche Scottish 911 had to be, or no, I'm gonna go with the Porsche.
The RWB 911 Turbo. It's just a spicy Beetle, except this one is really fast.
How fast? Okay, you between this versus that. And then, oh my.
You're in a This Versus That event. The guys and I do it all the time. We put two cars on the grid and see which one is the fastest. We can only compare cars for the fun of it. Don't worry if you lose. Well, let's see if you bet on the right horse. Two competitors today belong to the collection of a true Volkswagen nerd, me. These cars on track, it makes me feel emotional. And a little bit anxious, to be honest. Don't crash yours, please. I'll tell Gary the same thing.
Nice.
Like seeing a Jack Ferdinand Porsche fighting a buffed up August Cork in the octagon. In the red corner, the 965 Turbo, upgraded to over 400 horsepower with Japanese aesthetics. Love this. And in the blue corner, the 1990 Coupe Quattro with a big turbo that takes it up over 800 horsepower. A good little boy.
800 horsepower, like what?
And they're both insane. I'm not going to bed before kissing these two beauties goodnight. It calms me.
Come on.
My guys are preparing a first Gymkhana test for you over there.
Wait, what?
Things are gonna get real.
Oh my lord.
The end is near. Oh boy, it's gonna be tough watching either of my babies lose. If you wanna push the car to its limit, now is the time.
That's nice.
All right. Ah, you did great. But honestly, that this versus that was heartbreaking to watch. On one side, you've got this 1990 Audi Coupe Quattro that took me a mere 2 decades to see crazy hill climbing beast. And on the other, the ultimate goal for any VW Audi Porsche nerd like myself. One of the first two cars that Rawell ever built outside of Japan. Check out the hips on that thing. I know we patched this whole thing together, but I just can't watch either of these lose, so I'll just, yeah, I'm just gonna keep my eyes closed for this one. All good? Can I open my eyes now? Let's meet at the foot of the volcano. It's time to put your skills to the test. An actual Gymkhana.
Alright, okay. Which it, hi guys, okay, anyway, again, this way, I am going to be winning some field here, towards yet. If you guys, manage your seal, and then seal 3-2 to subscribe, if you guys, manage your seal, and I will see you guys in my next one. Goodbye.